Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. This channel is about sharing Rhino knowledge to students and professionals learning various Rhino 3D techniques. Today we would like to talk about this two-tone twist bangle, and twisting element has been using in the jewelry design a lot. I would like to show you the little trick and tips that I use for this bangle. Are you ready? Let's get started. Let's go to our front view and to draw ellipse. I'm going to set it the size for 60 by 55. So I'm going to type it 30 here, holding the shift and click, and 55 divided by 2. Okay, so as a bangle, we need to have an opening. And again, the opening is really depends on your customer's wrist and how, you know, how much opening you need to have allowed to have a wrist to get in. So I'm gonna draw a line in the angle there and mirror to the other side, and let's go ahead to trim the one that we don't need. So that will be our opening. Okay, so we need to know how long is this. So let's go to the command bar and type it length, L-E-N-G-T-H. Okay, and we're gonna pick up this curve and it tells us it's 150.612. So we're gonna make a curve that is going from the top view and it's 150.612. Okay, so this is like if you stretch out this curve and how long it's going to be. All right, so we need to create our design on this curve. Let's go ahead to creating the profile. Going to the curve tool, you have rectangle tool, and snapping at the endpoint of the straight line we just create. I'm gonna set it up the length for 7 by 2. So this is the profile that we're going to have. Let's go ahead to copy that one from the endpoint to the endpoint. So we want to make sure that, you know, when the surface is created at the end, they will be straight, that we want to control the end. Okay, so that will be the curve for the first surface. The second surface, which it's going to be a little bit higher in the middle. What I like to do is to rebuild this curve and then make it into the 5 point and degree in 3. And then what we wanted to do is to move the point in the center. We are going to move it up a little bit. Okay, so the first surface, we can simply just using the loft tool. We're gonna loft straight from here to here. So that will be your first surface, and let's cap it. Okay, the second surface we are going to do is, instead of using the loft, we want to use the sweep one. This is going to be our rail, and this is the curve. So we're gonna have our second one like this. Let's go ahead and cap it so it will be solid as well. Okay, I'm gonna look at it one at a time, so let's go ahead to hide that one. Okay, so within this one, since it will be harder after harder to do the fitted edges after we twist, so we want to fitted the edges right now. On the four corner, I want them to be a little bit rounded, so let's set it 2.5, and that should take care of this one. And this one and this one, so it's not that sharp when you try to wear it. Okay, and then the rest of it, let's put it into radius, let's say 0.8, and we want the radius all over. Okay, so we got really nice rounded edges there, so when you wear it, it's not scratch your skin. Let's bring back the one we just hide, and let me put this into other layer so it's easier to see. Change the color as well. Okay, so we finished that red one, that's hide it. And the second one we want to do exactly the same thing. So let's set it as a 2.5 and pick up four corner. After we do that, we want to change radius to 0.8 like we did before. And this time we want to select all over. Okay, so just want to make sure there's no naked edges and everything. It's fine. Okay, now we have those two. If you are going to make one tone, which you don't have to assign different material, you can go ahead to bowling right now. And if you are not, like what I like to do is two tone, then you want to keep them separate without bowling it together. That's temporary to group them. So it's easier for us on the model. Every time we'll select both of them at the same time. One of the important concepts about twisting is where the axis is going to be. So let's go ahead to try twist, and that's snapping into the midpoint of that profile and the midpoint of this profile here. All right, so let's go to the right view, and that's holding the shift, click on the X axis, and let's do 360 degree, which is one turn. And let's take a look on the perspective. Now you look in the perspective, they look beautiful, beautiful. Okay, this is really nice and flow. However, the problem is the curve that we have supposed to be on the construction plane. That means any part of this middle part, when you flow it back to this surface, will be inside of the bangle. And for the jewelry design purpose, you always want to avoid things get inside of the ring shank or inside of the bangle, because it's gonna be not comfortable. So we need to make sure that when it twists, it's nothing or something really minimal for the bangle. Okay, so what I like to do is I need to find where's the center axis for both of the form. The command I'm going to use is called bounding box. So go to the command bar, type it bounding box, and it will pick up your object and you hit enter. Then it will give you a box. What this box means is this is the maximum area that cover entire piece. Okay, so our center, instead of where the profile is actually the center. Let me turn on the endpoint so I can snap into the corner to the corner and snap to the corner to the corner. All right, so now I no longer need bounding box. All we wanted to do is finding the center point, which will be the diagonal line that I just draw, the midpoint of that that line. So I'm just gonna put a dot there so it's easier for you to see. So now this is our new axis. Let's take a look on what it's going to affect our twist. We are going to do the twist again, and we select this object, but this time from this midpoint to this midpoint is our axis. And I'm going to do the same thing, 360 degree. So now we keep it above the line possible, above the construction plane possible. So that way we can flow it back better. So now let's flow this shape back to the bangle. Let's go to the transform, and you have flow along the curve. Let's pick up this one, enter, and you pick up the base curve. And make sure you pick up the same corner that the same side that you pick on the curve. So then you will have it flow really nice back to the original curve. I would like to thank you to watch and share and leaving the comment for my video. It's been helping me a lot on my YouTube ranking. Please keep doing so I can reach more people and share my knowledge with them. Thank you. I'll see you next Monday.